Hey there, this is Editor G, and we are here with this special. We are at the Kalaari Summit, where just about anybody you wanted to hear from in the world of venture capital or startups, some of the most exciting businesses out there, and some of the most exciting speakers. This is a special playlist coming to you from the Kalaari Summit. And we have with us, of course, the legendary Vani Kola, who's really an inspiration to so many people and has really reset the way the entire venture capital business really functions in India. Vani, just wanted to ask you, Hindustan Hamara, which is the concept of what this entire Kalaari Summit has been about, what's the concept out here that we as a country should look for business models that are suited to us and to our specific circumstances? Don't just copy from outside.
To us, the Hindustan Hamara is about solving for the unique needs of India in only one way, which is embracing of India's diversity and India's needs. Of course, lessons can be learned from everywhere. And I think, in fact, as a society, we are very good at it. But to solve for the India challenges, we have to find Hindustan Hamara solution.
And that's also perhaps important because there are, in a sense, so many different Indias. North India, South India, Rural India, Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3,
women,
Alpha, Beta.
Yeah. Absolutely. You know, luxury, semi-luxury, premium luxury, ultra luxury, value, affordability, across age, you know, and digital literate, digital not literate. So across so many cuts, that's India, which is not one country. We are the least homogeneous of countries. But having said that, if you have the right insight, right solution, I think we have a deep market. I say this because there is also a skepticism sometimes, you know, globally around, is India a shallow market? India is actually a very deep market, but you have to pick the right problem to solve and have the right insight that binds us in some ways.
And now here on EditorJi at the Kalaari Summit, the man himself, Vijay Shekhar. What is your sense of the overall ecosystem? What are the basic messages that you are giving people right now?
I think it's clear that India has a big opportunity for technology companies. Consumer base of India has finally happened. We now have hundreds of million consumers. Consumers who are transacting, if you want to say, consumers who are valuable for others to target, so advertising revenues, and consumers who are consuming huge amount of content. Now you know that how we are largest video consuming country in the world. So I don't think that anybody else could have asked for something else added on this layer. Obviously, the resources and the money, etc. requirements have also gone higher to play in this market, but we are at a big market now.
So is that growth because more and more people are so what is it because?
Network
is it
effect.
Is it network effect
of more consumers are getting used to, more merchants are getting used to, more consumers are liking and telling someone else to try it out, more merchants are getting comfortable and understanding the value of it, and that they are asking consumers to try it out. We have yet not added layers and beauty of things like that. You can get credit out of it. Consumer credit has started coming in. We launched Paytm Postpaid and so on, stuff like that. The idea is that right now it is convenience centric and a little bit of benefit, the cashback centric.
If you take a look at the logic of a lot of other things that are happening, you know, the Jandhan accounts, all of that logic is there. Aadhaar is still there. It's not gone away despite the privacy concerns. Universal basic income or minimum income, as the Congress is saying it. Payments directly to bank accounts. The logic all seems to be this: keep on shifting ourselves to a digital payment and a mobile payment system.
It is.
Which is probably very good news for you.
Not just me, I think it's a good news for country at large and everybody else in the ecosystem also. I'd say that, look, if we want to be a couple of trillion dollars more than what we are today, so we are about $2+ trillion and we want to be $5-10 trillion, I'm sure we want to be and obligately should be a digital technology company, economy. I mean, America uses plastic and China uses its phone. We do need our plastic and phone variations of those. So it's an obligation for a $10 trillion economy to have a digital.
If you're doing it. So overall, optimistic? Elections coming, could be a process of change. How optimistic are you today, right now?
I'm very optimistic. I think the best part about Indian economy is that whatever may happen, we in next 7 years will have a double the economy. $2.5 trillion more being added. I'm happier on that for any day.
What a number of very special sessions on stage. We got a chance to hear some very, very influential people, from Manoj Modi to others. Let's take a look at that.
You know, we talked about regulation. So is this a right time to continue to invest in India?
I see a lot is going to happen. I don't think regulation should decide or define that, right? I think disruption is going to happen in several forms. I think it's a two-hour answer. I'll try to give my high-level views on this. So first of all, just technology enablement of a lot of things we do is going to happen, be it healthcare, be it transportation, be it, I think some amount of retail has happened, payments has happened, but it's going to go on. Organization of unorganized, which also has started in some way, is going to continue in a big way. But I think one thing which we have not seen too much in the country, which I think is going to happen, is consumer goods. I think consumer durables, non-durables, the way consumer companies have been built is entirely marketing driven versus product development or consumer driven. So I personally believe in addition to all the other stuff we spoke about, I think fintech is going to get disrupted, the movie industry is going to get disrupted, consumer goods are all going to get disrupted. So yes, continue investing in a big way. Yeah.
Great, so for all those entrepreneurs, find a way to reach Kalyan when you're looking for an angel investor. And Mukesh too. But Mukesh, what do you think about investing in India right now?
I think it's the best time ever. I think, you know, I mean, the previous speaker talked about, you know, next 8 years, $1 trillion GDP will get added, and another $1 trillion over next, you know, 5 years or 4 years. I think things are really accelerating. I think we are, you know, very, very early days of such a big country taking off, I think, you know. And I think someone also mentioned that if you have a 25-year view, it's actually scary how homogeneous everything looks like despite all the quarterly or yearly drama. And if you just extrapolate that next 25 years, I think it's going to be just phenomenal. Now, depending on what kind of entrepreneur or investor, you need to be able to take that long-term view and, I guess, navigate the short-term volatility, which is also pretty much given, as Rashesh, you know, talked about. So if you can navigate that, and I guess, you know, different investors, obviously different cycles, the fund cycle, etc. So if you are able to take, you know, 5+ year view, I think it's, I don't think time was, you know, any better before. So it's every year is getting better.
So how does the relationship between Reliance and startups, how does that get shaped? And I'm just using that as a broader word, not just Jio. So do they collaborate with you? Do they compete with you? What are your thoughts?
See, I don't think we are in that sense competing with anybody. We are trying to just, Indian market is so large that no one player can provide everything and everybody will coexist. I think creating this Jio ecosystem, what we have done is really opened up so many opportunities for everybody to do everything in digital and virtual space, which was not otherwise possible. We are working with multiple startups. We believe that they bring a lot of new thinking and new way of doing things, and that really helps us do things little faster than what we could have otherwise been able to as part of larger Jio and Reliance system. So we coexist, we use multiple startups, technologies in achieving our end objective. We are also investing a lot, so we have no problem in funding these startups. So as they will focus more on their core competence of doing new innovations and putting technologies to better use. I think it's a really win-win complementary kind of a relationship that we have.
Well, what a pleasure to have with us Amit Singhal, the man behind Google Search. You with Google Search and the other things that you had done in your earlier avatar. Now, of course, you're running the Sitare Foundation, finding ways of giving back. Is there anything specific that you're looking for? Any specific people you're trying to find whom you can help? Is it charity alone? Is it finding the right people to back who can grow businesses and find answers that can transform the nation? What is it?
The way we look at Sitare Foundation is that India has infinite potential. Like the numerous startups that you see out there, our youth, our fifth graders, our 12-year-olds are those found Sitares waiting to be found. We find the best ones using various techniques. and then we fund them, we take money out of the equation. In India, if you are not born in a rich family, chances of your making it to where I am sitting today are very, very low.
Well, great to have Priyanka with us now from Pop Expo, one of the people who's really building out new businesses and finding new ways to do things. This entire Hamara India, Hamara Hindustan idea and the ways that you can find new business models going forward. Exciting space right now, or are there still lots of challenges in the new digital world?
I think it's both, actually. The opportunity is so huge, and it's ours for the taking. And the great thing about content is that you have to be a local player to understand. Context is as important as content. So an Indian publication like PopExo, women writing, telling you what's the best red lipstick for your skin tone is way more valuable than kind of finding it on the internet written by some American or Australian publication. So context is important, plus we understand the user. What are her pain points? What does she care about? Mother-in-law versus best friend versus husband versus boyfriend. So that Indian context is what we bring in picture. And it's Hindustan Hamara.
Okay, this entire Indian startup boom and how Hamara was Hindustan or concepts that are being viewed abroad, but who other than P.K. Gulati, the man who's really been actually mentoring and guiding a lot of the Indian ecosystem from abroad.
That's
What's
true.
What's the world, which way is the world looking at India? Just waiting to see elections mein kya hoga or something else?
Oh, well, you know, I don't think a lot of the world is caring in terms of the startup world. People investing in startups or people working with startups, I think they'll go on. They have seen ups and downs, political ups and downs. And the India story has continued, irrespective of what governments changed. I say that because of two reasons. First of all, the Indian market of a billion people buying things, doing things, they're not going to change. There may be a sentiment dip, but it won't last forever. That's one. That confidence does exist. And the second thing is a confidence in Indians exists. So Indians do certain things good. Like if you look at global startup ecosystem, Indians have a place in terms of being, you know, go to Silicon Valley or go to England, you find, you know, Indians having a, you know, pride of place there. That's not changing either.
A bunch of young people were here. They were all talking to us, giving their thoughts. Let's just show you some of the people who came here to the Kalaari Summit and their views on the way they see the world right now.
The rich diversity of India is a very interesting, you know, strategic, you know, aspect for us, and that is what we are building. And, you know, we think, you know, we need to enable experiences on platforms that the next billion people understand, driven by people they trust in the language that they know. So, you know, going vernacular, their local language, leveraging video, using voice as a communication tool, and enabling experiences on top of messaging are you know, the four most important you know, aspects that anybody should think of if they want to completely, you know, leverage and reach out the diversity of India.
My three wishes for India at this stage would be that India continues to look at cross-border opportunities, takes full advantage of the potential rift that's between US and China, and takes over the manufacturing, supply and logistics of various industries that China has been providing up till now. My second wish is to have a progressive and strong government back in place so that, you know, we do not fall into policy paralysis once again. And my final wish would be that the RBI keeps the currency stable, because quite frankly, as international investors and family offices, that's what really keeps us awake at night.
I think the biggest challenges for India even now remain the gap of wealth that we have between the haves and have-nots. And that gap of wealth is also leading towards not only poverty but hunger. So I believe if tech can come out with solutions to really reduce this gap between the haves and have-nots, which is very possible, and also to ensure that there's no poverty left in this country, I think that would be a fantastic achievement as far as India's digital prowess is concerned, because it is at the cutting edge of digital technology.
For India, the old saying was the roti, kapda, makan. Now going forward, looking forward for us, it's going to be the housing for all and the non-polluted or the organic food for all, and specifically the energy. So I hope to see that India one day to use the all the renewable energies. We have enough solar energy with the battery technologies improving, and then we can move towards that one. So if we can provide to all our citizens a place to live, a good food to eat, and you know, safe energy, that's a dream that I have for this country.